Hello friends, I still remember the time when I did my first options trade. I was not sure if I have done all the necessary steps. I was worried if I was missing anything. In case of options, there are a lot more things to look at as compared to a stock trade. So I thought to make this video to help others in placing their option trades. In this video, we'll go through all the steps that should be taken to sell a call spread to ensure that you have complete understanding of all the checks and balances that you need to perform before you confirm the trade. So, we are talking about selling a call spread or selling a call vertical or selling a call credit spread. They all mean the same. The ticker that we are interested in is Bank of America. First step is to go to the options page or options section or trade section on your broker platform. The broker platform that I am using is Thinkorswim. Make sure you are looking at the correct ticker. Yes, it is BAC. Once you have confirmed the ticker, next you should look at the expiration period. There are multiple expiration periods listed here. Pick up the expiration period that you want to sell an option for. I'm not interested in weekly, so I will go with the next available monthly option, which is April monthly option. Once you have identified the ticker and have identified the expiration period, next you need to select the strike prices. Let's expand the expiration period to see which strike prices are available here. Because we are interested in selling call vertical, we'll focus our attention to the left side of the options table. That's where the data about call options is. Please note that the call vertical or call spread is a multi-legged option trade. To be specific, it has two legs. You will be selling a call option and receive premium, and buying a call option and give away some of that premium. Since this is a net credit trade, you will be selling a call option at a lower strike price and buying the call option at a higher strike price. Let's see how we do this. First, select the short strike price, means the strike price at which you want to sell the option. Let's say it's $30. Click on the bid because we want to sell, and bid is the price at which buyers are willing to buy. Then go over to the long strike price, means the strike price at which you want to buy the option. Let's say it is $31. Then press the control key on your laptop and select the ask price, because we want to buy and ask is the price at which sellers are willing to sell. This will create a call spread with a width of $1, which is the difference between the long strike at $31 and short strike at $30. Because you press the control key, Thinkorswim considers all the legs to be a part of a single trade. In the order entry section, Thinkorswim will automatically create a spread order for you. You should review each element. Spread, it's vertical, check. Side, you have the sell and a buy, check. Quantity, ensure that the contract quantity is correct here, check. Ticker, it's BAC, which is Bank of America, check. Expiration, that looks correct, it's April 2019, check. Strike price, pay attention to make sure that the strike price are correct for the buy and the sell call options. Next, premium. That's the amount of a net premium which is shown. If you want to change the premium amount, you can click on the positive sign to increase the premium or negative sign to decrease the premium. Next is the order type. Make sure it is limit. Never ever place a market order. Newbie option traders who come from stock trading world generally do this mistake because it is common in stock trading for retail traders to buy the stock at market price. However, in options, it could hurt really bad. I had committed this rookie mistake in early part of my option trading. Ouch! And it still hurts. You should not do this. So ensure that the order type is limit. Next, the validity of the order should be day. I never suggest to keep an opening order beyond the current day because you don't know what might happen overnight. Stock could move, volatility could change. We retail traders don't have a capability or a capacity to monitor it closely. So don't let your opening orders go beyond the current date. Next is exchange. You may ignore it. Thinkorswim will route it to the best exchange it finds. Or if you really want to send the order to a particular exchange, you can select that exchange from the drop-down. Now, once you are satisfied with all the values, then you should press confirm and send to confirm the trade. I hope this helps you in placing your first trade confidently. If you have any questions, please write it in the comment section or email it to optiongeek@gmail.com. If you like what you learned, please subscribe to Option Geek channel and help me spread the word so others can also benefit from it. Thank you very much.